There's a new superintendent in Miami-Dade County Public Schools.
Could cameras be mandatory in classrooms?
Driving near or far, it's important to know the dangers of distracted drivers. Students, spring break starts soon.
This is Falcon Vision.
Welcome to Falcon Vision. I'm Alexandra Guerrero.
And I'm Alejandro Reyes.
Miami has a new superintendent who transferred from Collier County, Florida.
Dr. Jose L. Dotres was formerly a chief academic officer for Broward County Public Schools. Superintendent Dotres has launched Twitter and Instagram accounts as a way to learn, share, encourage, and build relationships among all stakeholders in a way that complements his face-to-face interactions. Connect with Superintendent Dotres by following him on Twitter and Instagram at SUPTDotres.
So I started today, my day, with trying to make sure that I thanked the teachers, the custodians, the food service workers, the clerical staff, the school leaders that are basically the frontline workers for our school district.
Cameras in classrooms? Could that be a new policy? Let's find out more with Monica Moraga.
A bill making its way through the Florida legislature are allowing school districts across the state to put cameras into the classrooms and record teachers and students. This could be a big change for classrooms. Let's see what our Falcons have to say about it.
It's like a double-edged sword. I think it's good in some cases, but also an infringement of our rights.
We are professionals. We know what we're doing. We went to school for this. We're trained. I think teachers deserve the respect that we have earned as educators.
I don't think that there should be cameras in the classroom because children deserve a safe space where they can be themselves and talk about things that they would never talk about outside of the classroom.
Two Republican members of the Florida House of Representatives introduced HB 1055, which states the purpose of the cameras would be to record incidents such as bullying.
I feel like they won't ensure safety because people kind of feel like it's like an invasion of their privacy in that type of way.
I mean, it's always good to have evidence, but students will not, like, I know that most students won't like the idea about cameras in classrooms.
I feel like kids will figure out a way to go around the cameras and still do what they want to do.
Teachers would be required to wear microphones while classes are in session. If the bill passes, school districts would be required to vote on the bill by January 1st, 2023.
I think it's a way for politicians to filter the information that teachers are delivering. I think that at the moment they put cameras on the politicians and their meetings and their dealings, then I'd be willing to allow them to do the same thing to me.
Well, I would say off the top of my head, it probably infringes on academic freedom.
The general agreement is that these cameras will suppress free speech and privacy in Florida schools. Is student safety worth more than the rights of teachers and students? It seems like most people think not. I'm Monica Moraga for Falcon Vision.
Distracted driving can have dangerous consequences and can cause a ripple effect in the lives of many people. Guest speaker JC Good shared her story with students here at Ferguson. Today at Ferguson, two guest speakers came to talk about the dangers of distracted driving. Here's what they had to say. JC Good and Steve Johnson are public speakers and advocates for phone-free roads. Since JC's miraculous recovery from the 2008 crash that claimed the lives of both her parents and left her partially paralyzed, a crash caused by a distracted driver, they have worked tirelessly to educate the country and world about the dangers of phone use behind the wheel.
So I'd like to, want to introduce you to a friend of ours.
My name is JC.
Hi, Alexis.
Hi, Dash. Justin, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. I just really quickly want to have a chat, tell you what happened to me. When I was 21 years old, driving home from my college graduation ceremony, driver on his phone. He was so distracted. He turned left into the intersection at a red light. Another car, an 18-wheeler, swerved to miss him and hit my family's car. And the resulting collision actually killed both of my parents. I spent 2 months in the hospital fighting for my own life. So the big message today, there is nothing on a phone that's more important than a life. I lost my parents and almost my own life because of another driver using his cell phone. And phones are incredible, but they shouldn't be killing us. And I hope these students can use that to be a little better on the road.
It's important to remember the dangers of distracted driving and why you should never use a cell phone while driving a car. I'm Alexandra Guerrero, reporting for FBN News.
Having so much time off from school means it's a great time to catch up on some Academy Award nominated films. The Oscars will premiere March 27th at 8 p.m. on ABC. Here's Lauren Capote with her pick of which nominated films to watch.
Hi, my name is Lauren Capote, and since the Oscars are coming up on March 27th, I thought I would talk about three movies that are up for nominations. The first film on this list is Don't Look Up. Don't Look Up follows two astronomers who discover a comet that is headed towards Earth. After finding out this information, they desperately try to tell everyone in the world, but no one believes them.
I'm sorry, but not everything needs to sound so goddamn clever or charming or likable all the time. Sometimes we need to just be able to say things to one another. We need to hear things. Look, let's establish once again that there is a huge comet headed towards Earth. And the reason we know that there is a comet is because we saw it. We saw it with our own eyes using a telescope.
Don't Look Up was one of the most talked about films that Netflix came out with in 2021 despite all of its mixed reviews. Don't Look Up was surprisingly now nominated for 4 Oscars. Best Picture, Best Screenplay, Best Film Editing, and Best Original Score. It also stars well-known actors like Leonardo DiCaprio, Jennifer Lawrence, Meryl Streep, and Timothée Chalamet. The next Oscar-nominated film is Encanto. This film follows the family Madrigal and a special candle that gives each member of the family a superpower, except for one. One of Encanto's Oscar nominations was Best Original Song. Surprisingly, however, this nomination didn't go to Encanto's most popular song, We Don't Talk About Bruno.
We don't talk about Bruno, no, no, no. We don't talk about Bruno.
So waiting day.
We were getting ready and there wasn't a cloud in the sky.
No clouds allowed in the sky.
Bruno walks in with a mischievous grin.
Thunder.
You're telling the story or am I?
I'm sorry, mi vida go wrong.
Bruno says it looks like rain.
Why did he tell us?
In doing so he floods my brain.
Abuela gets the umbrella.
Married in a hurricane.
What a joy.
Disney did not submit this track for an Academy Award nomination, so there was no way for the Academy to vote for it. However, We Don't Talk About Bruno is still a very popular song with over 135 million Spotify streams.
The last movie on this list received 7 Oscar nominations, West Side Story. This remake of the 1961 original was directed by Steven Spielberg. West Side Story follows Maria and Tony, who meet and fall in love at a high school dance. They are forbidden to see each other, which fuels the fire between their two rival gangs. West Side Story is now streaming on Disney Plus. Thank you so much for watching, and make sure you tune into the Oscars on March 27th at 8 o'clock p.m.
Living in Miami means we live in paradise filled with pools and beaches. Here's Annabella Diaz with tips on tricks to plan the perfect pool day for spring break.
Are you looking to plan a pool or beach day this spring break? Well, I'm here to give you 3 tips on what to bring to make that day a success. This is Tips and Tricks with Annabella. Tip number 1, sunscreen. I know it's self-explanatory, but you would be surprised how many people forget to bring sunscreen or just don't feel like they need it at all. The sun can cause serious damage to your skin, and it's important we stay protected. Here are some of my favorites. Tip number 2, stay hydrated. Make sure to bring lots and lots of water when being out in the sun. It's very important too, as being out in the sun for a long period of time drains you and can cause heat exhaustion. And tip number three, clean up after yourself. We all love the beach and the pool, but we especially like seeing it nice and clean. So maybe next time when you go out to the beach or the pool, bring an empty garbage bag and throw all your garbage and waste in there. So at the end of the day, you can wrap it up and take it with you. I hope you enjoyed these tips, and I hope you have an amazing spring break. This was Tips and Tricks with Annabella.
Spring break is coming up soon, and with so many things to do, some people might need help deciding. Here's Thomas Guajardo with student plans for the break.
We went around school asking people what they're going to be doing for spring break. Let's see their responses.
Here with the man, the myth, the legend, Spoto. What will you be doing for spring break?
Going to Punta Cana.
And what will you be doing for spring break?
Sleep.
That's it?
Yeah.
All right.
Beach, party. And my house and the park and crumble cookies.
Mm. All right, and like you, parties with you? What? What? I'm going spring break?
Yes.
It's up in the air. And what will you be doing for spring break?
Definitely going to the beach.
All right.
With the birds.
With the birds. Anyone in mind? What will you be doing for spring break?
Spring break, papi. Working.
Working?
Yeah. I'm working in Publix in the night.
I'll definitely have to visit you.
Hi, papi. Hey.
And what about you? What will you be doing for spring break?
What I'll be doing for spring break? I'll probably be at the beach.
At the beach?
Yeah.
I'll be studying for the SAT, and I'll be working, and I'm also going to work out on my fitness and my physique. Why? Because it's very important.
Those are some great responses. Have a great spring break.
Falcon Vision's Lauren Capote is directing John A. Ferguson's drama debut on The Wizard of Oz. And luckily, we got a behind-the-scenes look on the event.
Are you ready to go down the yellow brick road? John A. Ferguson's drama department has put on their ruby slippers and are ready to go see The Wizard. We've got a backstage pass to look behind the curtain. What's the hardest part about being in a school play?
Oh, it's definitely the schedule, because you have to manage between classes, maintaining your grades, and having to stay late in school, learning your lines and everything.
Before the show, I always end up like rapping or like doing something very fast, just like something to release energy, because I want to keep my energy up for the show.
Once rehearsal started, I had to teach everyone the blocking, and then the choreographer had to come in, teach them the choreo. And during all of that, I had to make set pieces, which was very hard, and I struggled, but we were able to get it done.
The new thing that I had to learn was like doing like actual special effects makeup, like wrinkles, making someone look old, making someone look scared or tired, but actually changing the whole face. Yeah, that was probably like my biggest pleasantly surprising new thing to learn about.
I think it's like working with like different face types for sure, because when you're doing ensemble, you have to kind of like figure out what looks good on like each person. Not everybody has the same like face structure. So that was very interesting to see how to like play around to make everything look cohesive. Mm-hmm.
I think the hardest part of being in a school play is knowing that people that you go to school with is going to see their play. So it's like you see these people in the hallways and they're like, oh, hey, you're in the play, right? That's awkward.
I agree. Or like if they're like gonna make fun of you, they're like, oh my god, you're in the play. Or like asking teacher for extra credit. Oh my god, that's so scary. Having to like go up to the teachers.
It took me a long time to memorize the lines just because it was a little bit hard. And so I would practice every night after school and just repeat it over and over again in the mirror. And that's how I kind of prepared for the role.
Then close your eyes and tap your hands together three times. And think to yourself over and over again. There's no place like home.
Honestly, this school play has been like the only thing that has helped me feel like myself. And when I step on the stage, it just makes me feel like home. Like I really, really love it.
There's no place like home for Troop 6822 other than the stage. And be sure to be on the lookout for more shows by Ferguson's Drama Department. I'm Nancy Socorro, signing off with FBN News.
Do you believe in good luck? St. Patrick's Day is March 17th. And in honor of this holiday, we have Mia Salamon with more.
St. Patrick's Day is all about the luck of the Irish. Today I'll be going around Ferguson to see how lucky Falcons can be. Any good luck charms you have, why is it lucky?
I'd say my grandma's necklace because I feel like she's always with me and she gives me a good luck.
Do you believe in luck? Why or why not?
Yeah, I do believe in luck. I feel like luck is what brings us together as people.
Yes, I believe in good luck because if you believe in good fortune will come to you.
What's the luckiest thing to ever happen to you?
I was negative in my bank account and then my parents accidentally sent me $100.
My best friend Susie because she's always there for me.
The luckiest thing to have ever happened to me is one time when I was at a studio session as a guitar player that I was hired for. It was kind of like a big like warehouse of studios, and in one of the rooms there was supposedly like a big artist, and it turns out that that artist that was recording that night was Post Malone. And I tried to like look through, but there were no windows and stuff. But I went to the bathroom, and as I was coming out, I saw him going into the room.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Irish.
Irish who?
Irish you a happy St. Patrick's Day. This is Mia Salamon with Falcon Vision.
I'm really looking forward to spring break.
Definitely. I can't wait to hit the beach.
Thinking about the beach makes you reminisce about the movie Teen Beach Movie.
Well, great, because we leave you off this special music video to kick off your spring break. This is Falcon Vision.
Think about you, you know that I'm never gonna lose.